Hello students, welcome back to storage area network classes. Moving on to the next topic, fiber channel storage area network. As per the syllabus, this is the topic from second module. See, communication of the data communication is very important for that is one of the key feature or essential feature of any organization. So just in time information to business users, it is expected that business should operate for 24/7 and all the information should be updated throughout. That is, it should be updated throughout the duration, that is 24/7. Integration of information infrastructure with the business process. The storage infrastructure should be integrated with various business process without compromising its security and integrity. Then it should be flexible and resilient storage infrastructure. So it should support for it should have the flexibility like support for various operating systems, or it supports for addition of servers, right? So these are all the key requirements of any business process or an organization by considering communication as one of the key feature. Here, one of the application we are going to discuss, that is about the DAS, Direct Attached Storage. DAS, it is called as, is often referred to as the stovepiped storage environment. Stovepiped storage environment. That means host itself will be having a storage environment, okay? Direct Attached Storage. The server itself will be connected directly to the, or itself will be having a storage array, okay? Storage environment. See, hosts own the storage and it is difficult to manage and share the resources on these isolated storage devices. So efforts to organize this dispersed data led to the emergence of the storage area network. Here what happens is each host or a server will be having its own storage array. So managing the data will be difficult because it is better to keep the data as a centralized storage, right? So if multiple servers are connected, it can directly look into the particular storage area to have an access to the data. But here what happens is you have to communicate, you have to find which host is owning the data, right? And you have to communicate to the host, and followed by that the host will fetch the data and so on, right? So that's why and topic is evaluated, that is storage area network, dedicated network for or dedicated channel or dedicated area for storage. So FCCN overview. In this chapter we are going to discuss much about the fiber channel communication. Okay, so FC technology. FC stands for fiber channel. Fiber channel storage area network, where fiber channel is used for communication purpose, the optical fibers, right? Where the data loss is less, right? Here is the overview about the FC or fiber channel. So FC architecture forms the fundamental construct of the FCCN infrastructure. So FC or fiber channel is a high-speed network technology that runs on high-speed optical fibers fiber cables and serial copper cables. Okay, most of the here material used is the fiber channel, and some copper cables are also involved here. So it tells you about the evaluation of FC technology and all. So just go through the description. Speed and all given, say 640 Mbps throughput, okay? Data rate of 3200 Mbps, right? Yeah, here is the storage area network and its evaluation. SAN carries data between the server or the host and storage devices. So host will be there one side, or server other side, storage array or storage area network will be there. So in between there should be a connector. Now what is the connector? The cable. That cable we are going to discuss. Fiber channel is the connecting device. Now here you can see the diagram. Multiple storage arrays, right, are kept one side, and multiple hosts are or servers are kept on the other side. See, hypervisor is also a server where it runs with more than one operating system using virtual machine. That's it. So they are connected. You can see the interconnection line, interconnecting lines also through FC-SAN, Fiber Channel Storage Area Network. So in its earliest implementation, the FC-SAN was simple grouping of hosts and storage devices connected to the network using FC hub as a connectivity device. So this configuration, so we are using hub as a connectivity device from host to the storage area network or storage array. So this is called as FCAL, Fiber Channel Arbitrated Loop. Okay, the topology is called as. We'll be discussing much about the FCAL later. One more, we have FCSW using switches instead of hub. That is there, okay. This diagram tells you about the fiber channel SAN evaluation. So initially, its FC hub is used, server to storage array using interconnecting device FC hub. Then later on, multiple devices are used. So interconnection of SAN, FC switch fabric, okay. A hub as well as switch is also used, followed by FC switch in multiple layers are used. These are the various configurations. We say fiber channel SAN evaluation, FC SAN evaluation technology. Next comes the components of fiber channel storage area network. See FC SAN components. First one is about node ports. So fiber channel components, it start with a port, isn't it? You have to plug in a cable to a port, right? Whether it is a USB port or any other kind of port it is, right? You have to plug in the cable whenever you want to have the connection. Check your computer also. You can see the various plugins, plug-in cable, though, cables over there, isn't it? Now we are talking about the components of FC-SAN. So the first component is the node ports. So in fiber channel, you can see the diagram. So node can be any device. It can be host or it can be a storage array. Please remember, one side there will be a host, and other side there will be storage array. So node can be anything. Either it can be a host or it can be a storage array. And these nodes will be having various kinds of ports for different operations or different purpose. So port 0, port 1, port 2, port 3, and so on till port n it is marked. So port 0, port 1 till port n. Each port will be having two links, right? Each port, please remember, so this is the elaboration part of each port. Each port, if you look into each port carefully, you will be able to find two links, one for transmission, other one for receiving. So transmitting and receiving links. TX refers to transmission, RX refers to receive. Okay, that is all about the node, port, and link. Then we'll be having cable and connectors, right? So cabling, we are referring to fiber channel. So SAN implementation use optical fiber cabling. Copper can be used for shorter distances for back-end connectivity because it provides an acceptable signal to noise ratio for distance up to 30 meters. So up to 30 meters, the throughput of copper cable as well as fiber cable almost same. So we can use the copper cable also, right? And as distance is larger, what we are supposed to do? We have to use OFC, optical fiber channel. Right. So there are two types of optical cable available, multimode and single mode. So multimode fiber and single mode fiber. I think diagram we have for them. Yeah. Multimode fiber and single mode fiber. Left hand side diagram stands for multimode and right hand side stands for the single mode. So optical fibers will be having a core and a cladding, two areas. Core as well as cladding. The innermost part is called as core and outermost part is called as cladding. So cladding just for user for the protection purpose, it won't do any kind of transmission. So the inner part, core, where the actual transmission takes place. So you can see the diagram beam of light, multiple beam of light. can be passed through multimode fiber and multiple beam of light, multiple ray of light can be, or multiple signals in general can be transmitted simultaneously. So it follows the total internal reflection, right? The ray which hits the surface, which will be reflected to the other part or opposite part of the core, again it will be reflected and so on. In this way, the signal will be transmitted. So multiple signals can be transmitted in multimode fiber, whereas single mode doesn't support for transmission of the multiple signals. That's about the multimode fiber and single mode fiber. Okay, this is all about the connector. Any kind of connector, it can be USB connector or your connector, what the one which you are able to see on the phone, 2.5 mm audio jack, whatever it is, right? So any type of, any kind of connector it is. Next is about the interconnecting devices. So interconnecting devices, as you have seen in the diagram, so hub as well as a switch are the most commonly used interconnecting devices. Hub, which establishes the FCAL, fiber channel arbitrated loop, and switch, which establishes the fiber channel switched fabric, FCSW. Such type of topologies are established. Okay, so hubs are used to as a communication device for FCAL implementation, and switches for FCSW implementation. FCAL and FCSW we'll be discussing this much about them. Okay, switch will be having another control circuit called as director, so which will direct the path of the data. So mainly we have discussed, now we are discussing about the components, right? The components we have started, components of FC SAN, that is fiber channel. It starts with a connector, that is node port, followed by connector, this one cable and all. Sorry, it starts with a node port, followed by connectors, cable and connectors. Then finally, this one also we have discussed about, say, interconnecting devices. Then last, SAN management software. SAN management software, it is to be installed on the host or on the server, you can say, right? This is used, it manages the interfaces between the host and interconnecting devices. Next is about the FC connectivity. So fiber channel connectivity. So FC architecture supports three basic interconnectivity options. One is point-to-point connection. Next is arbitrated loop, that is FCAL, and the last one is FCSW, or fiber channel switched fabric. It is also called as. So point-to-point connection is a simple approach. So there is no interconnecting device here. Very simple approach it is. You can see the servers or hosts on one side and storage area on the other side. What is done is there is no such interconnecting device is used in between. Only server we have, servers we have at one side, other side we have storage array, and in between there is nothing, just a cable. It can be used for shorter distance. Okay, the cable which is inserted from the host, one side on the host and other side on the storage array. That's it. Direct communication, point to point communication it is called as. Next is the fiber channel arbitrated loop. Here you have to use hub as the interconnecting device, as we have discussed earlier. Here is the diagram. FC hub. Earlier, what is done is we have just used the we have not used in the previous diagram. See the difference. Here, FC hub is there in between, but in the previous diagram there is nothing, right? Hence it was called as point to point. Now this is called as FCAL configuration, or fiber channel arbitrated loop, where hub is used as the interconnecting device. All the servers or hosts are connected to the hub. From hub, it is connected to the storage array. So operation of FCAL and FCSW in detail we'll be discussing. Just go through the diagram now. fiber channel switched fabric FCSW. So here what is done is, instead of FC hub, FC switch is used. You can use a single switch or multiple switch. Okay, so inter switch links are also available, just to demonstrate that it is considered, multiple switches are considered here. So interconnection or inter switch links there, and switch can be connected to the other switch, where multiple switches are used here as the interconnecting devices. Right, there is a bidirectional path between each switch, you can see, right, between them, among them you can see, and there is a connection from host to storage array. All the three hosts are connected to a common FC switch, which will be connected to the another FC switch, and that the second FC switch is connected to storage array here as per the diagram. You can use the single FC switch also, not an issue. You can see the two tier and three tier architecture of the switch. So FC director, which governs the data, which will be normally there at tier 2, and FC switch will be there on tier 1. And it also has got a, this is what tiered structure of fiber channel switch fabric it is called as, tiered structure of FC switch. We can observe that in on three tier architecture. We can observe the three tier architecture also when multiple switches are available. So on tier 3 also you can see some FC switches where it is connected to the director of tier 2. Okay, so data governing of the data, that is done by the directors. So FCSW transmission, fiber channel switched fabric mode of transmission, port ID are marked. Normally it will be having four ports. Okay, port 1, port 2, port 3 and port 4, as you can see. So each port will be having two types of links. One is for transmission, other one is for receiving. So transmit and receive. You can check the arrow mark. Transmit towards the port is transmit, and away from port, which is receive, right? So transmission and receiving, one-to-one communication, one-to-one on diagonal way also. So if you want to communicate between 1 to 3 and 2 to 4, in FCAL, what happens is there is no such a thing. You have to go for inner loop only. From diagonal way of communication is not possible in FCAL, that fiber channel arbitrated loop. That also will be able, we'll be discussing the diagram for that also, right? But in case of FC switch, one-to-one communication is allowed even in diagonal way. So port number 1 to port number 3, direct communication is possible. Port number 2 to port number 4, there is again direct communication is possible. So node B to node D communication, where the arrow marks are highlighted, right? Arrow marks are written on bold, black color. Just check. Port number 4 to port number 2, right? Or port number 2 to port number 4, whatever. So even though they are not adjacent ports, but communication is possible, direct communication is possible. Okay. Next is about the switched fabric ports. Ports of, there are various kinds of port. We identify the port with the port ID, or see type of port we can say, based on the usage. Based on the usage, see, commonly used available ports only there, but based on the usage we name the port. Okay. With different labels. One is N port. If node is connected to the particular port, if you have connected a node to the port, then we call the port as N port. Node can be a host or it can be a storage array. F port, sorry, E port, a port that forms the connection between two FC switches, then it is called as E extension. Okay, multiple switches can be connected, right? You can connect a port, a switch to the another switch, as you have observed in the previous diagram. Multiple switches are connected, isn't it, in the interconnection connecting devices. So a port can be used to connect to the another switch. So interconnection between the switches, in that case port is marked as E or extension port. Then F port, a port on switch that connects a node port. It is also known as the fabric port. Okay, fabric port. G port, G for generic, it can be used for any purpose, either E port or F port. As you can see here, so node port, N on the side of the server or storage array, it is called as N. On the side of the switch fabric port, it is called as F. Then again, F port and N port you can observe here, right? N port towards the storage array it is called, and F port towards the switch. A switch connecting to the another switch. You can see they are marked as inter ISL stands for inter switch link. E port and E port they are named as F port again for fabric, N port again for the storage array. So another important concept. Okay. The ports of FC switch. Next we have the fiber channel architecture. So you have to see the fiber channel protocol stack in the fiber channel architecture. So let us discuss about this in the next session. Thanks for watching. See you in my next video.